Hi, remember this video where I explained the differences between deCONZ, Zigbee2MQTT and ZHA in Home Assistant? Well, I migrated from deCONZ to Zigbee2MQTT using my Conbee 2 stick and I'm not happy at all. Let me tell you why in this video. I bought a Conbee 2 stick a few years ago. At the time, I had linked this in Home Assistant using the deCONZ add-on that you can download from the add-on store. This worked very well. My lamps responded quickly and all devices I have are supported by them. See the video on how to install deCONZ. The only thing that I couldn't do so easily was to update the firmware of my devices. I then decided to make a comparison between ZHA, Zigbee2MQTT and deCONZ in this video. If you want to know the pros and cons of these three systems, you should definitely watch that video. After doing that research, I decided to take the plunge and switch to Zigbee2MQTT altogether. I wish I'd never done that. If you want to switch from one system to another, you have to do quite a bit. Since I didn't have a second stick at my disposal at the time, and I was very satisfied with my Conbee 2 stick, I wanted to transfer everything in one go. It's not possible to run both deCONZ Zigbee2MQTT and ZHA via the same stick. These were the steps I had to take to transfer everything. I had to pair all my Zigbee devices in Zigbee2MQTT again. Then I had to give all those devices the exact same entity IDs they had in deCONZ. Then I had to go through all my dashboards to see if the devices and their entities were still displayed properly. And it turned out that I also had to make some changes here and there in the dashboards. And then I also had to go through all my automations, scripts and scenes to see if they still worked. In the end, it took me about 2 weeks to get everything back to the way it was before I switched from deCONZ to Zigbee2MQTT. So I was happy. Right? Well, no. Then the drama started. What struck me most was that my lamps reacted a lot slower, especially the lamps that I had put in light groups in Home Assistant reacted unreliably. For your info, my production environment is a Home Assistant Blue that should just have more than enough capacity for my house. Sometimes some lights wouldn't turn on or off when I tried to switch a light group. Sometimes lamps would not respond when motion was detected by a motion sensor or when I pressed a button. The latter only happened occasionally, but lamps in a Home Assistant light group were a real drama.
A real drama. It was such a drama.
Well, then I decided to put those lamps in a Zigbee2MQTT group. I preferred not to do that, but it seemed the only solution at that time. When I started using Zigbee2MQTT groups, my lamps responded better when I controlled such a group, but sometimes there were still lamps that did not respond well. The most annoying thing for me was that I now had to create groups in Zigbee2MQTT and adjust all my automation scripts and dashboards again. Well, finally, I found a smarter way by populating my Home Assistant groups with groups from Zigbee2MQTT. Then I would at least no longer have to adjust my dashboards, automations and scripts. But then again, now I had groups from Zigbee2MQTT in groups in Home Assistant. That felt kinda I didn't really want to go back to my old install now, and now I was able to update the firmware of my devices over the air, so I liked that part. Until I shot this video from last week about scenes in Home Assistant. Man, I've been fighting a lot with scenes in Home Assistant in combination with my Conbee 2 stick and Zigbee2MQTT. Really, at about 50% of the time, my lights were unresponsive, slow, or displaying the wrong colors. It was a complete disaster if I wanted to control single lamps that were part of a group. When I controlled the light groups from Zigbee2MQTT instead, things got better, but every now and then some lamps still did not work. This time I had several sticks at my disposal and I thought it would be a good idea to try out the latest Sonoff Zigbee 3.0 USB Dongle Plus ZBDongle-E. Now I already had Zigbee2MQTT running on my production environment, so I couldn't try that new stick with Zigbee2MQTT on my production environment. So I decided to test that stick with ZHA first. When I connected the new Sonoff stick to my Home Assistant server, I was able to install it with ZHA without any problem. That was done according to the same procedure as I show in this video here. Pairing a few lamps, a Kara motion sensors and an IKEA Treasury remote went without any problems. But now came the test. I made some scenes with single lamps to see if they would work properly. So I didn't use groups as the ultimate test. And guess what happened? If my videos help you, and if you want to stay up to date with my tutorials and not miss anything to increase your knowledge of Home Assistant and Smart Home, subscribe to my channel and tick the bell. It also helps if you post a comment. This way more people get notified about my videos. Oh, and don't forget to hit the thumbs up for this video. This allows me to make more tutorials for you. By supporting me, you also support my work as a music therapist to help people with mental issues. Thank you. The lamps responded super fast and correctly every time. Occasionally, there was a lamp that reacted a little slower than the other lamps, but in the end, the lamp did respond in the right way. What a relief! Everything responded the way I wanted it to. In the end, I replaced the individual lamps with the groups I made in Home Assistant. Anyway, that's still not a good comparison, of course, because I was testing with ZHA right now. To make sure that the problem lies in the combination of the Conbee2 stick and deCONZ, I also had to do a test with Zigbee2MQTT and the new Sonoff Zigbee 3.0 USB Dongle Plus ZBDongle-E. So I decided to put Zigbee2MQTT on my test environment and connect the new Sonoff stick to it. Of course, that was not as easy as installing ZHA. It turned out that for this new stick, I had to do some extra things to get it working in Zigbee2MQTT. In next week's video, I'll show you how to get the new Sonoff Zigbee 3.0 USB Dongle Plus ZBDongle-E working perfectly in Home Assistant. So, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so, so you won't miss that video. When I had the stick running on Home Assistant, I linked the same lamps to my test environment and created new scenes that called these lamps via Zigbee2MQTT. And guess what? The lamps responded quickly, and even without using Zigbee2MQTT's light groups, they responded correctly. My conclusion is that the Conbee2 stick is not reliable enough for Zigbee2MQTT. At least, not for me. Fortunately, the new Sonoff stick does not cost that much. I've put a link in the description of this video where you can buy it. I get a small affiliate fee for it if you buy it through that link, without costing you extra money. This way you support me a little for creating this video. And now some tips if you like to migrate from deCONZ to Zigbee2MQTT or from ZHA to Zigbee2MQTT or vice versa. My first tip is, if you have a Conbee2 stick, stick with deCONZ. This stick works best with deCONZ, period. My second tip is, buy a second stick so you can run both systems side by side and migrate step by step. That will save you a lot of hassle with the rest of your family. And then tip 3, if you already have groups in Home Assistant, register your Zigbee2MQTT groups in the Home Assistant groups so that you don't have to adjust your dashboards, automations and scripts afterward. I hope this video helped you, and I want to thank everyone who has supported me in making these videos and tutorials so far. I could never have done this without you. Thank you. If you also want to support me, see how you can do that in the description of this video. With that, you make it possible that I can continue to make these videos for you. Oh, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.